Greetings, everyone. Greetings and welcome. Thank you all so much for coming to join me today. As always, I greatly appreciate everyone's company. And, you know, all the other good things that come from us getting together to enjoy the progression of non-progression, as it were. I know, right, Just Alex? These games have such fantastic soundtracks, don't they? Demon Protector, welcome. Rosie Tina, welcome as well. Brosifs, Freedom Stick. And my regular crew from Discord, I see Talios, Xenifer, my mods, Gulthrax, Phyly. The Dark Fallout, it's been a little while. Hey man. Just Ryan. And first time viewer, Hunter in a Box. Thanks for stopping in, man. Hey everyone. Welcome, welcome everybody just arriving. Talios, well, I'm talking about you guys. I don't really do much socializing in my spare time. Because most of my not spare time is spent producing YouTube videos and generally being at my day job, so my free time I tend to spend just recovering. Taking some precious downtime. Talios, don't take offense to the fact that I don't show up every day. That's what happens when they're just to get everything done. Glad to hear it, Rosie Tina. GMK Goat, you make it sound so much more impressive and important than it is. Alright. Well, tantamount to non-progression. Let's do something other than just sit here. Phyly, what are you even talking about? Minaten, dare I ask? I mean, I'm glad you're happy. Yeah, Ryan, I can think of a couple of different bosses in Bloodborne that would induce that kind of response. Mr. Steaks Fridge Chan? No, I haven't seen her yet. Phylus Matthias. Oh, glad to hear that, the random purrs. We'll cross our fingers, Rosie Tina. Hey, the random purrs! Riker Skies, you dropped in just at the start. So, you might have noticed, but something is a little bit different today. I've decided finally to mess around a little bit with the online elements of this game. And so we've got Master Hand and Crazy Hand over here. Remember, this was originally a Vita game. And is meant for touchscreen compatibility, which is possible on the Vita TV. So that's what this looks like, but these fingers, Water the Wet, are for controlling the online elements of this game. And for example, one of the online elements that you can use is this little command over here that says voice. And what this does, and we even get a little help message here, Wow, Phyly, give me a moment. Poor you. He's been sitting around making no progress for this entire playthrough, and now you want me to poke him. The voice command will display the five most popular actions among other players. on the day you happen to be dealing with. And there, okay. So this is just one of the online elements you can use to get a hint from other people as to what maybe you should be doing on a particular day. Hey, Gibbed! Welcome! Thanks for stopping in, Gib. Good to see you, man. How have you been? This is what people did today. It's a little bit overwhelming, isn't it? I'm feeling just a bit overstimulated. Yeah, water the wet. That was my reaction too the first time. So, one way or the other, pretty much everybody is spending time with their waifus. We've got one vote for spending time with Kanji, one for spending time with Adachi, and literally everything else is waifus. I think that's enough of that. Yeah, kind of, Mina 10. But it's ads that you know. Hey, Panliska! Oh, there were two Kanjis Town Nomad? I didn't catch the second one. If only, Mimir's Leiche. If only. Yeah, Filey, let's not. The thing is, if we can manage to actually get to some combat today, which I kind of doubt is going to happen, but if we can, some of the other online elements in the dungeons are really interesting as well. So let's head on upstairs. Oh! Dropout Dragon! Thank you very much for the host. I appreciate it. Your viewers are probably just coming off of a PvP session, and I can't promise them combat today, unfortunately, so, thank you, Dropout. Thank you for the raid. Thank you for raiding a game that you think is bad. I appreciate that all the more. Welcome, everybody from Dragon's Stream. Mimir's Leiche, you might get your wish. Frosty, thank you so much for the subscription. Really appreciate it. Glad to have you, man. Yeah, pretty much, Filey. I would not be the least bit surprised if all of Dropout's viewers are just thinking, Dropout, what the hell are you smoking, man? You raided us to this idiot playing this game? We want PvP scumbaggery, not waifus. Case in point, Mastery Zero. Case. Welcome, Scythen, and everybody from Dragon's Stream. If only I were ready, nowhere to hide. Unfortunately, I haven't even had a chance to properly play through Dark Souls 3 on my own yet. Okay, well, boy, now the pressure's on to actually make some progress. What was it I came up here to do? I think, let's do some translation. Because that's fun and will surely entertain all of my viewers, especially those who just dropped in from a Dark Souls 3 PvP stream. Works out just, Ryan. Thanks, Acronym. Glad to hear it. Oh dear. Alright, let's use context, because guessing is never a good idea when you're translating. Sivan, I actually don't remember. I believe the next dungeon is going to be Naoto's, and I think that should be sometime within the beginning of the next month, maybe the end of this month. Oh good, I grasped the meaning through context and now I'm in the groove. Oh, Frosty, I was talking to Ryan, just Ryan, another user. Ryan, just Ryan, the problem is we've got a few Ryans here in chat. Holy cow, 12,000 yen. I've gotten good at this. I'm a translating OG. Alright, Frosty, thanks for dropping in, man. And thanks for the resub. Oh, I came downstairs? What? Hang on a minute. Really? There's another action I can take? Huh. Or did I just, did I just waste the day? Social link. Because I could swear... Yeah, damn it, that's not what I was supposed to do. Well, fortunately, it's fine, because we didn't even progress at all. So, I wanted to, yeah, see, I thought it was night when I loaded the game. I didn't even pay attention to the time of day. I wanted to go advance the death social link during the day. Because, yeah. And Azrite, I literally just loaded this file at the beginning of the stream and had not made any progress since. So, I don't think it's really... There she is. S-Terminus! Thank you so much for the resub. Welcome back to the Ragtime Lounge. Thank you for pressing the button, S-Terminus. I appreciate it. Hey, Skelly! Since I have this super cool evil spirit of death, I'll probably get along really well with this nice old lady. Yeah. Let's do that.
Yes.
Yeah, Shiva the deceased. Thank you, just Ryan. Ah, Dragoon! Welcome! Thank you so much for the subscription, Dragoon. Welcome to the Ragtime Lounge. Glad to have you, man. Greatly appreciate it. Jeez, Bahamut, that's dire. Oh, boy. Yeah, who are you talking about? Oh, I remind her of her husband. Okay, sorry, just had to correct an issue. Apparently, one of my moderators was missing his sword. There we go. Sorry about that, Skelly. Jackety! Thank you so much for the resub. Welcome back, Jackety. Always appreciated, man.
Listen, dear.
Oh, okay. Well, now I can't do an impression of her. Because she's already given us the canon version. Does she look like death to us? Well... You know... I don't think it's lady she looks like death. That would be incredibly unbecoming. I mean, yes, she kind of does. But I'm not gonna say that to her face, for goodness sake. Oh, well, now she sounds disappointed. Maybe I should have told her she looks like death. Maybe she's just one of those nice old ladies who's down with the emo crowd and goes out of her way to look like death. Oh, now I mustn't become death. Well, and her social link is even called Old Lady. Poor old lady. Panliska, I never thought of it that way. Hey Mo, welcome! I'm doing alright, thanks. How about yourself? Yeah, Phoenix Wright, I can appreciate your position. If you're not already familiar with the social link system from the Persona series, this is a little bit tricky to explain, but it's basically, you improve your relationships with people, which then powers up your capabilities in combat, is the really, really simple version of the explanation. So here, kind of maybe implying that she's the one who killed him, maybe explaining why she asks if she looks like death. Phylus Matthias, I would call it more a just general relationship simulator rather than dating specifically, because you also do things like go to school and cook and work day jobs part-time and jump into the TV to fight evil monsters that are based on the human psyche. You know, things that every regular student does. Hey, Handsome Robles! Hey, RPG Nerd! Yeah, much better, RPG Nerd, thank you. I'm finally over that miserable illness.
Goodbye.
Yeah, Hisano is actually the origami killer. So Phoenix Wright, the deal is... The deal is, Phoenix Wright, that, this game uses a system whereby, you use these things. They're sort of like spirits, aspects of the main character's soul. And, you summon them in battle to perform attacks for you. These are the proxies that use your skills. Physical attacks your characters do on their own, but any kind of magic type stuff, they use these things, they're personas. And you'll see that each persona has an arcana from the tarot listed. Abmael's is death, principalities is justice, Jack Frost is magician, and these are arcana from the real tarot deck. Although, I think some different decks of tarot had one or two more or fewer arcana, but basically the tarot is a divining tool, and the idea here is that you have relationships with different people throughout the game, each of which correspond to one of the arcana of the tarot, and by improving your relationships with the person of the corresponding arcana, your personas power up, and they gain new skills, their stats increase, and they therefore become more useful in battle. So, yeah, if you can kind of wrap your head around that, Phoenix Wright, hopefully that helps a little bit. But this has been a convention ever since the early Megami Tensei and Shin Megami Tensei games. Yeah, it's not unheard of, Skelly, for so many of these games to borrow influences from other franchises. Yeah, a stand simulator is one way of looking at it, Water the Wet. Hey, Faded Enemy! Hey, what is my name? Yeah, Squatus, it becomes a little bit more intuitive once you've actually played the game from the beginning, because you get a little more context. Bahamut, the irony is that penis monster is actually a figure, and in fact a very central and important figure from Buddhism. That's Mara. And I suspect the reason he takes that form in Atlas games with sinful pleasure and seduction and corruption, that sort of thing in Buddhism. Hey, Drum Major, welcome! Glad to hear it, Anthropos. Thank you so much. All right. Now we're going to do the part-time translating job. All right, and, oh, we're given a different set of options this time. Interesting. I think, yeah, sometimes it's best to just reread the passage. I've reached my set goal. Well, okay. Oh, wow, and that actually affects the outcome of the I should have skipped it and come back later. Oh, well, it's not like I need the money. Hey, Nightwing!
Oh.
Pretty much true, Water the Wet. Oh, hey, Yukiko remembered her umbrella this time. How about that? Have I seen the weather report? No, but I have this sneaking feeling there's a slight chance of rain. No, Mimir's Leiche. No, I'm not going to save Scum that. Case in point, Squatus. I love that you can just... Yeah, no. I trust the police with this case so far. Yeah, Twixarino, the funny thing is, if you just let that scene hang on one line of dialogue, the road will loop infinitely. So you apparently have to go through like a corridor of time or something in order to get to school in this game. Yeah, holo process. Maybe we should leave them alone. Mimir, my uncle can't go into the TV. He's at an inherent disadvantage. Oh, we get our exam scores today. Yes, perhaps we should check the test results. Hey, Grimlock! Glad you could catch a stream finally. Welcome! Glad to have you. Faded Enemy, welcome back. Thank you so much for the resub. Very much appreciated, sir. Yes, Phylus Matthias, adults can get personas. But, for the most part, you only see young kids and teenagers use personas in this series. Well, Adachi, the thing is, in Japan, they do affect your future. They actually look at your test scores for university applications because it's extremely competitive over there. And you can't just buy your way into a university of your choice like you can in some other countries. I got the highest score. How about that? Hang on, and I think I might have just missed another sub. I did! Malkavian Madness! Thank you so much for the sub, Malkavian Madness! Welcome to the Ragtime Lounge! Pleasure to have you, my friend. Well, I guess I'm a genius. Oh, look at that. My social link friends seem to be looking at me admiringly. Idiot Adachi. I feel that I became closer to everyone because they think I'm a super huge badass now. And then we all went to class. Anthropos, what did you expect? Oh, head of the class! Fantastic! See?
We're finally free!
I'm such a genius, I got a trophy! Hey, DCD! Welcome!
Hey, why don't we go somewhere during summer vacation? My motorcycle's back from the shop!
Back from the shop?! How did they put that thing back together?! It was, like, blown to pieces when Hanako sat on it. Water the Wet, I don't know specifically if that's true, but I would be inclined to believe it. I don't know if it would spike after exams, but again, exams are a pretty big deal in Japan.
Hey, you guys have motorcycles? Lucky you!
Says the idol who earns more than enough to have a motorcycle of her own if she wants.
Your scooter's fixed? Surprised they got it back together after Hanako-senpai, was it?
Oh, Kanji. Read in my mind.
Did something happen with Yosuke and Hanako-san?
Oh no, don't ask, Chie. Don't ask. It was all just a terrible misunderstanding.
He's striking out with the ladies and got his scooter busted up.
I love how Kanji explains this to them. This is... Okay, Yosuke does not deserve this. He does not deserve to have Kanji cover for him like this. Like such a bro.
Oh, Yosuke's after Hanako-san?
Okay, I take that back.
I'll back you up.
I wasn't talking about anything like that. I was saying we should go somewhere over summer vacation, like the beach. It'd be a pain to go by train, but a motorcycle.
I haven't been to the beach in a long time either. The bright sun, the glistening waves, that luscious scent drifting from nearby stands, the dripping of meat juices.
Well... This LP officially can't sink any lower. Chie has just canonically uttered the phrase meat juices. Moving on!
Is food all you can think?
Hey, why don't we get our licenses too? It's just a written test, right?
Yeah, see? Now you're talking.
We can't. We're too young.
Oh, that's right! They're underclassmen! I forgot!
Sorry, Kanji, but my birthday was last month, so I'm 16 now.
Okay, well, Risei's age officially confirmed.
Hey, that's cheating!
That's not- how did you- Kanji's super salty.
Oh, but sitting behind Senpai sounds great too. I want to squeeze in close.
Get away.
Yeah, let me remind you that it's against the law to have two people ride on a motorcycle.
Those sweat drops, though. Also, thanks, Yosuke. You've actually saved me with a useful excuse for once.
Idea for you guys to get your licenses. It only takes about a week.
Yeah, you know, for once, Yosuke is thinking practically.
It's supposed to be for work, but there's a scooter at the end.
Oh, no.
We got one as a gift at the office that's just sitting around. I bet I could borrow it if I asked.
Who gives a scooter as a gift?
I'd have to call my manager, though.
Huh. Is this actually working out? How about you, Chie?
Bahamut, we might already have been through this in a stream for which you were not present, but, in Japan, the legal age is 18. Federal law trumps local, old, outdated prefectural laws.
A scooter, huh?
It can be any kind, as long as it's lower than 50 cc's.
Getting technical.
Then I might be. One of our relatives loves motorcycles. Maybe he has a scooter I can borrow.
I'll hold off on being introduced to him. You can probably hear the motorcycles out my window as we speak. Right now, there are motorcycles driving by.
Whoa, this might really happen! Let's all get our licenses and hit the beach together!
Hold up, what about Teddy?
I don't trust that furball on anything but a tricycle.
If he doesn't move around, he could pass his luggage.
Tan Nomad, it's a measurement of engine displacement. I believe it stands for cubic centimeters. Something along those lines. Fleetmaster Eddie, thank you so much for the subscription. Welcome to the Ragtop, friend. Really appreciate the support.
It's stretching a little.
Phylus Matthias, yeah. I still need to see if Plague will draw that picture for me.
It'll be fine. If we can't get him on with one of us, we'll just strap on some wheels and tow him.
Oh, God. Because that'll end well. Oh, no. Not again. Thank you so much, Fleetmaster Eddie.
What's so funny? Teddy? On wheels? Roller skates? It's perfect!
I still think a tricycle would suit him better.
I've made up my mind. I'm gonna get my license.
Well, you'd...
Beach, huh? I've gone before for pinup shoots, but it's been a while since I went for fun.
Moving on!
Oh my gosh. Does this mean... I'll get to see Rizette herself in a swimsuit with my own two eyes?
I said, moving on.
Can you maybe not talk about her like she's not here?
Hey, who are you looking forward to seeing in a swimsuit, Senpai?
Igor. I mean... You know what? I think... There is no question about which option we have to choose here.
Well, mine's nothing special. Crotchery's thin and built for speed, so...
Well... It was worth it just to make Yosuke mad.
Why in the world are you interested in Kanji's swimsuit? Cut that out, damn it!
He's so mad!
Anyway, looks like we're set on going to the beach. Yukiko, Chie, you guys should get your licenses too. Then you can ride motorcycles with us.
Well then, let's do this!
Kanji is the best, isn't he?
Yeah!
Tan Nomad, I'm not sure if Kanji was actually playing along or not. Like, I legitimately can't decide that one.
Oh, yeah!
Because he delivered that line so naturally. Well, that was worth it. Okay. Prancer of the Chili Canyon. I still can't get over that username. That's great. What am I trying to do here? Let's go into town. The dexterity build, Panliska. Hey, Jerp! No problem, man. Just trying to throw you a little bit more, action for the Fight Club. I hope it helped a little bit. Rosie-tina. I can relate. I won't hold it over you if you decide you need to go do work. Because, you know, getting fired sucks. Especially if you get fired because you were watching a stream. Speaking of which, I wonder if Namatame got fired for watching Twitch streams on the job. Oh no, that's right, he got fired because he had an affair. Nothing new from him, I guess. Fleet Master Eddie, I'm glad to hear it. Yeah, this guy has the right idea. Don't let crazy stuff bother you. Also, Egyptian. I wonder if he's talking about, Miss Sofue. Huh. Well, I guess there's some kind of backstory going on there. I don't know, Demon Protector. These, Persona streams are anything but efficient. Unless you measure efficiency by... They're incredibly efficient. But, gameplay-wise, not so much. Fabulbison, welcome! Thanks for stopping in. Mimir's Leiche, he does kind of matter later on. But for now, he's pretty irrelevant. Sleeping Neko, considering some of the items she's asked me for from dungeons, I wouldn't be surprised if she's just going around Inaba at night eating people's souls. They could release a whole other side story to Persona 4. Just about that. Sozai Daigaku, let's see if they have- Oh, okay. I guess it's only on actually rainy days, not just cloudy days. Well... I haven't hung out with, what's his name? And in fact, there he is. So let me actually make sure I have a persona. I do. Fantastic.
Oh, hi.
Hi. Your voice acting is sounding a little bit monotonous today. Ah, excellent. Oh, that shady character. This is an entire stream into itself. I'm not even sure where to begin. Perhaps somebody else in chat can point you in the right direction. Because if I try to do that now, it's going to sandbag the stream for about an hour. I mean, I would love to be able to help you and give you the crash course, but I think maybe that would be better handled by somebody in chat. Panliska, Naoki is Saki Konishi's brother. His sister is the girl that Yosuke had a crush on. The second, I believe, person to be murdered in the string of murders in Inaba. The broccoli hair. My god, handsome rubles. Phylus Matthias, the question was just, I've never seen a Persona game before. What are they? What am I watching? Starbomber, was he in the Golden anime? I don't remember. Because I saw the vanilla anime, and then... The golden one, pretty much they just added Marie. I don't remember Naoki specifically.
Yes.
That shady character, if you're looking for some place to start, I would recommend watching, but I've got a couple of introductory series on the newer Persona games on my YouTube channel, but if you want to really start at the very beginning, go to YouTube and search for a guy named Master LL. He's an Atlus OG, not a developer, but of a player of Atlus games. He's been playing Atlus titles for a long, long time, and he seems to really like the Shin Megami Tensei and Persona series in particular. He does not do voice commentary. His videos are all the kind of old-style long play walkthroughs with just gameplay. But if you want to go back a little bit farther than what you're seeing here, his channel would be a good place to start. He also does a lot of challenges, things like fighting the optional super bosses with one character, that kind of thing. He's quite good. Star Bomber, I haven't played the entire female campaign in P3P, but I interspersed it in the introductory series on P3 that I did to just give people a bit of an idea. Panliska, yeah, the anime is pretty good. I enjoyed it. It's kind of like a best bits sort of cut of the games because, I mean, you've seen how long this Twitch series has gone on. There's no way you could fit all of the plot of one of these games into an anime. But it was syndicated. There were, I think, 26 episodes. And I do own them, have watched them, and yeah, it's pretty good. I would recommend it if you enjoy the games. The wind was really strong. Now that's a top-class excuse for being late for... Sorry! I'm sorry. I was late for school because it was really windy. And I forgot my wind resistance accessory. So I took double damage. Bahamut, if you're referring to this Twitch series, it's gone on for probably... Oh god, well over a year now. And I'm only around, I think, a third, maybe halfway through the game at this point. I like the shark. Wow. You know, I really wish we had heard the first part of this story, because this sounds like a legitimately interesting and amusing story. Star Bomber, there are things I like better about Vanilla, and there are a couple of things that I'm not so hot about in Golden. But overall, the amount of content that's been added to Golden, I do appreciate. This poor guy! Naoki just has the worst luck. Like, who does this happen to? This is the sort of thing that just happens in... I hope so too, Rositina. I'm happy to have you here. Oh, was it the 5th of August? It feels like it's been over a year. But we're closing in on a year now, anyway. And it's gonna be well over a year by the time we're done. Yeah, Zalthin, Looney Tunes is a good way to explain it. Oh, jeez. Yeah, we're agreed on. Oh, if I'm understanding that correctly anyway, Rosie Tina, I'm sorry to hear that you haven't had such a good day. I certainly hope it improves. Hopefully, poor Naoki's antics will, serve that purpose. Now, here we go. These two gossiping idiots are gonna spoil the mood. What is my name? It's anime. I mean, come on. If you look at the hairstyles and hair color of everyone in our party, there's some bizarre, bizarre stuff going on. Naoki's hair is pretty normal by comparison, I would say. Yeah, Dark Devil, I saw. It reminds me of Tai doing PvP in Bloodborne with a steering wheel controller. That was great stuff. Oh, for God's sake, really? Oh, okay, yeah, no, this is the kind of thing you might hear. Oh, of course. How dare he look cheerful? How dare he enjoy himself? What a rotten person he is for having friends who care about him and want to cheer him up. I love how now they're identified as loud-mouthed housewife. Jeez. Talk about rude. Oh, come on, Naoki. Aritos! Welcome back, my friend. Thank you so much. Welcome back to the Ragtime Lounge. Glad to have you again. Yeah, it does seem that way, doesn't it? Oh god, Mimir. Naoki confirmed. Bleed build user. He probably scumbags it with a Karthus curved sword. Well, see, but he's trying to stay upbeat nonetheless. I appreciate him for that. Good on this kid. Haters gonna hate. Cutting Wolf! Thank you so much for the subscription! Welcome to the Ragtime Lounge, Cutting Wolf! Great to have you for the support, I truly appreciate it. Hey, Torun! Welcome! Glad you could make it. Thanks for stopping in, man. I hope you've been okay. Acronym, have you ever fought a Karthus curved sword user? Like, one who knew what they were doing? Cause, Dropout Dragon here was kind enough to show me a couple of days ago what kind of shenanigans are possible with the Karthus curved sword. And, yeah.
I'll see you again.
Oh, Oh, Gulthrax, what have we,
Welcome back!
What have we got here? Ah, Gulthrax. Can we just take a minute? We just take just a minute. Let's see here. Gulthrax, what have we... There we go. Yeah, Gulthrax, thank you for this. Great stuff. I really appreciate that. So now I'm officially canon in the Secret Squirrel universe. Is it sad that I know who Secret Squirrel is? Welcome! Now I have to catch up on chat. Bahamut, I try. Chat interaction is really important to me, but as you can see, it has the consequence that it took probably 20 minutes to complete a single social link event. So, there are pros and cons to this approach. Some people appreciate it. I'm glad when those people find their way here. Yeah, Torun, I'm amazed I, even remember Secret Squirrel. That was ages and ages ago. All right. And I think... Let's go translate some stuff. Yeah, we'll translate again. I think I desperately need the expression. Yeah, water to wet, that's what the term long play came from. Because originally it just meant, it just meant that you would play a game in its entirety. And it was usually for games like this that were actually long. Make a character from the Tales of series? 27, make a character, what are we referring to? Are you drawing a character? Are you creating a character in Dark Souls? Just Alex, there's only so good I'm going to get at multitasking. I've been trying for 31 years now, and this is as far as I've gotten. You encounter a sentence that seems to have been written for a child? Oh boy, this is tough. Translate the words properly or write it as a child would. Well, my job is to be a professional translator here. Written. The sentence lost its charm, but you achieved your goal. Yeah, I was afraid of that. Oh, I see, 27. I gotcha. Hey, Richfield! Ah, that sounds like an interesting blend, Richfield. I hope that experiment works out okay. Hey, Philboy, welcome! I'm hanging in, thanks. How about yourself? Yeah, I know, Acronym. Well, that's why I was torn. Hey! Welcome, thank you for stopping in. Yeah, Water the Wet, I've gotta hand it to them. They did a pretty damn good job making that choice ambiguous. Because from a professional point of view, yeah, I would want to translate it properly. But, you know, if on my own I were translating something, I would translate it in a way that were true to the original speaker, and in that case, yeah, translate it the way a child would say it. And that, interestingly enough, is one of the dilemmas that localization teams for video games like this have. And one of the best examples is that in Persona 3, there was a character named Bebe. He was a French transfer student, and I believe he was the Temperance Social Link. Bebe wasn't his real name. I think it was like Jean-Jacques something or other. I don't remember, but in the Japanese version of Persona 3, his dialogue was spoken in a really old-timey, samurai-style Japanese, which, according to an interview with some of Atlas's localization staff at, I think, a MAGFest panel in, like, 2006, did not translate well to English. So instead, they ended up handling it a completely different way in the English version of the game. And they had him just sprinkle in Japanese phrases in Romanji with a French accent in English. So, you know, there was... It worked out okay, but... these are the kinds of dilemma that you face when you're doing any kind of localization or translating work. No, Water the Wet, it actually worked out really well. It just happened that that was one of the difficulties they'd faced. And another one of those weird discrepancies was with Mitsuru in Persona 3, where in the Japanese version of the game, she would randomly throw in English phrases to be fashionable. And obviously they couldn't do that in the English version of the game because she was already speaking English. So they had her use phrases in French, which is why she's always saying, "Très bien, ha ha ha." Because it's fashionable. And in Japan, that's something they do fairly commonly. They'll use words from non-Japanese languages in a what's regarded to be a fashionable way, in advertisements, even in public notices and signs. And that's not unique. Sometimes you'll see kanji or Japanese writing used in the same way. Like, you'll open up an advertisement for a sushi restaurant or something, and it might be a sushi restaurant that's not actually run by native Japanese. And I remember the best time I've ever seen something like that is in New Orleans. There was a Chinese restaurant. I went to New Orleans on a trip to visit a friend many, many years ago. And there was a Chinese restaurant in New Orleans, or what claimed to be a Chinese restaurant, and the sign above the door had some kind of made-up symbols that were clearly not Chinese. They were not part of the kanji alphabet at all. And it's that sort of thing, you know, people will use lettering or phrases from foreign languages just because it looks exotic and... Ah, yeah, I can understand that, Demon Protector. Future Kaze, that's my American impression of a French accent. I can't really claim to do the French justice. Torun, why is everything slightly blurry? I hope you're okay. All right. I understand that you're all excited about vacation, but we're having the end of term assembly in the gym now. Oh, great. I won't say anything mean like someone I know, but please do what you're told. So even she held Morooka in contempt. I'm guessing that's who she's referring to. Oh no, I don't want to hear about your swimsuit. Oh, I'm sorry to hear it, Rositina. I hope everything works out okay. It's lawsuit waiting to happen, teacher. Yeah, that's pretty apt, Holoprocess. Miss Cougarwagi. Prancer of the Chili Canyon. My hat's off to you, sir. You know, when she's not busy trying to flaunt her... I still kind of think she's maybe not quite as bad as Morooka in terms of how she treats her students. Yumi looks super unhappy. Oh, Gulthrax, I've been around a little while. I know a little bit about DC characters. All right. And I guess we still have no choice but to wait for further progress in the investigation. But you know, I think maybe we should go pay her a little bit of attention. Question is, do I have a persona of the Sun Arcana? Yes, I do. Perfect. Fleet Master Eddie, your sister ate your homework. Or drew pictures all over it. Well, 2730, it's kind of a running joke, the way that this game uses it, but, genuinely, in Japan there is an attitude that if somebody is suffering, you should mind your own business and not get involved. And, again, I guess that's not unique to Japan, but it's fairly common there. Yeah, let's,
I see.
I can't say that I've seen that movie, unfortunately, though. Zoro, dude, I think that might be... overdoing it just a tad. I'm not sure I would be immediately inclined to believe that excuse if I were his boss. I would think so, Water the Wet. Hooray, my expression increased. And Yumi's not here. Well, I wasted my social link time today. Oh, she's at the hospital again, of course. And clearly we came here to visit her. Yeah, she doesn't like her dad. For those of you who might have missed that. Oh, and her dad's trying to make up with her. Oh, yikes, Fleet Master Eddie. That'll throw your back out real quick. Glad to hear you're getting out of there, man. Best of luck finding something that suits you better. I hope you, get yourself a nice, relaxing job where you can earn tons of money and not have to work very hard. Pexa! Thanks, appreciate the enthusiastic greeting. Yeah, damn it, this is a hospital. Stop disturbing all the patients in your selfish fit.
I'm sorry.
Hey, Deep Freeze Lightning, welcome. Well, about the only thing I can tell her is, yeah, you're not alone. So what if other people can understand what I'm going through? No one can understand what I'm going through. But that's fine. I guess we all have those moments of irrational emotional outbursts, don't we? Because we're all human. Oh, that's very kind of you, Fleet Master. I'm sure they appreciate having someone like you looking out for them. Ah, 27, Igor looked almost exactly the same. His design was the same, it was just the art style games, but Igor was basically the same through pretty much all of them.
Bye then.
Eh, water the wet. I've seen adults do it too, plenty of times. I think what it really boils down to is,
welcome back.
You put just about anybody under enough stress, and they'll blow up. It's just that everyone has different limits. Yeah, Panliska, that I could get on board with. And as far as I'm concerned, Gulthrax, yes. Let's see.
Well.
Oh. Oh, Nanako made me something. Oh, she gave me a paper armband. Thank you, Nanako. You're the best. That was an accessory. Let's see what it does. A bracelet from Nanako increases all stats by 5. Holy hell. All stats, and here I've got a power belt that just increases 1 stat by 2. Nanako, you just became the hero of this playthrough. Not that you weren't already. And I guess the moral of this story is, if you want to become huge, get an elementary school student to make your accessories. Gonna have to have her forge my weapons from now on, too, I guess. Yeah, no kidding. Plus 5 in all stats is nuts. I put on this cute little paper armband and I just became huge. It's amazing. Oh, I've got to go to my room and watch the Midnight Channel. I can't do anything this evening. Oh, well, I could check the fridge. Nothing, of course. Apparently, Adachi, yeah! Brosif, I don't think I'm quite huge enough to fight the Reaper just yet. It's gonna be a point. Oh, Fabelwesen, oh. Huge.
Very good.
Prancer, yeah, that would be great. I would love that. Oh, look! Someone appeared. It's an extremely vivid image. Hey, it's that fish co at the beginning of the game! Also, didn't he have a different voice actor in the vanilla version of the game?
Then try and catch me.
As he should, Torun. As he should.
Did you see that? Who was that guy? I don't know him. Have you ever seen him on the news or some television special? He seemed really gloomy. Like a zombie. Yosuke! Yosuke! Hear you! Sorry, I'm gonna give the phone to Ted.
Oh no, please don't. Okay, Rositina, thank you so much for joining us. Thanks for stopping in, and thank you again for being such a nice participant in chat. Hope we get to catch you another time when your internet is working a little bit better.
I finally got to see the Midnight Channel with my own eyes. Now I know exactly what's happening.
Oh, that's right, because Teddy is hanging out with Yosuke now. He's at Yosuke's house, so now he can see. And yeah, this is Teddy's human form. He got huge too.
It's clear now that it's not being filmed by anyone. Mystery solved. But that could be inside the other world. What are we gonna do?
Well, this is pretty obvious. Granted, he probably also would have said that if I just said we're going in like idiots. So So, Richfield, what you might have missed a couple of broadcasts ago is that Teddy grew himself a body inside his fursuit after he kamikazed on Shadow Risei. He literally just spent time lifting weights and getting huge. And as a result, he gained a human body. So I suppose you could say that that's his evolved form.
I think my heart skipped a beat.
Oh, that's right, Adachi. It was sit-ups. Thank you. He probably did some crunches and burpees in there as well, but, you know. Teddy is a reverse furry. Yeah, you could put it that way, Sleeping Neko. Yes, Torun, Teddy is the Star Arcana. Yeah, I wonder why that might be.
I was just talking to Yukiko. Was that?
It's a long, long game. The German Liger. I would give it probably 70 to 80 hours if you're playing it like a normal person and not trying to do a Twitch LP of it as I am. At this rate, it's gonna take longer than that. Oh, jeez, chat. Yes, the random purrs. Indeed. Oh, thanks, Mimir. I've already got some, though. I've got, some Organic Assam, and thank you for reminding me of that.
Okay, Risa and Teddy are checking out the other side. So we'll go ahead and start the meeting. Now, about what happened last night. You guys all saw it, right?
Yeah. Shit he said made my blood boil. That mumbling of his and those fish-like eyes pissed me off even more.
Oh, even Kanji thinks he looks like a fish. I feel vindicated.
Who the hell is it?
Oh, God. Wow, that, Lord Avalon, thank you so much for the $15 donation, and I've also just realized, thanks to you, that I apparently left my, desktop speakers on. I'll have to go fix that in a moment, but, let's see. Lord Avalon says, "Hi, Franz, just wanted to say thanks for streaming P4G and showing me this great game and series. After watching your VODs on YouTube for many episodes, I had to get a PSTV myself and play through this amazing game. It was the best gaming experience I've had in many years. You have my sincere gratitude." Lord Avalon, you're more than welcome, and I'm glad you're enjoying it. Thank you so much for the support. I really appreciate it. Really, really appreciate it. And now I'm going to go turn my desktop speakers off. Boy, that feeling when you hear a fat minister laughing in your ears and behind you. Ugh. Kids, always check to make sure that all of your other audio sources are muted before you begin streaming. Yeah, sorry, handsome Robles. I don't know, I really like the donation sound. Matter of fact, I think I'm going to, play it again. Because it's funny, haha. Alright. Well, I'm not convinced he's the killer.
Under normal circumstances, I'd agree.
When I noticed how clear the image was on TV, I knew something was different.
Gavlon, thank you for the $5 donation. Gavlon, rather unsurprisingly and true to form, says, "With Gavlon, you will, you deal." Well, Gavlon, profit share on all of the wheeling and dealing. Appreciate you cutting me in on that, man. You're a bro.
So I called Chie, and while we were talking, it hit me. Maybe that boy is the culprit.
Starbomber, yeah, if we're talking about Kingdom Hearts, Demix is the guy with the guitar who uses water attacks.
It's just a hunch, but it makes sense.
We've been told the suspect is a high schooler. The police are after him for the murder of King Moron.
Zane, I love the idea that there's just a pawn shop somewhere with a couple of tankards on either side of the sign, and in big old-timey letters it just says, "Gavlon's Emporium. We wheel and..." I would totally check out his inventory. Might find an old CDI that I could use for some awesome Let's Play- No, that's terrible, I would never do that.
So to see that on TV last night, at a time like this?
Doride, King Moron was the previous teacher. Kinshiro Morooka was his name, hence King Moron. It's a bit of a portmanteau, and he was murdered. And strung up like all of the other victims.
I mean, he even taunted the viewers, saying, "Try and catch me."
No, Drum Major, you did not.
So?
Let's say there's this high school student. We'll call him Shin. For some random reason, who knows why, Shin is able to enter the other world.
Interesting that they're using Shin as the nickname here, because one of the more common readings of that pronunciation is the kanji that means true or truth.
Then Shin, again for some random reason, starts throwing people into that world intending to kill them. The police can't prove the other world exists, so it's the perfect crime. He can't possibly be caught.
Does anybody still have that Photoshop of Mr. Morooka's face on the front of a steam locomotive with his teeth as the cowcatcher? Because that would be fantastic. Moril! Thank you so much for the resub, Moril. Welcome back. Support. Very, very grateful to you. Thank you again.
Now, imagine you're Shin, but after a while, people stop dying when you throw them in the TV. You don't know why.
Oh, that shady character. I'm glad somebody actually watched the E3 footage from last year. I unfortunately probably won't be able to go this year because I'm just too busy. But you never know. I might be able to make some other event this year that I'll be able to get some footage at instead. But yeah, no, I'm glad you enjoyed it. And yeah, Peeve doesn't look like you would expect him to look, does he?
You want to kill King Moron, but the TV is out, so you have to do it personally. Now the police are on to you. As a result, you, I mean Shin, is a wanted criminal, and there's no place...
No, Mimir, you didn't.
So, you're saying he went into the other world to dodge the cops?
It's actually a pretty solid plan, as long as you get out before the shadows eat you.
Oh, so that's why he said, catch me if you can. Wow, Senpai, you're smarter than you look.
Jeez, you can piss me off sometimes.
Well, Moril, so am I. At least, if you believe some of the comments I've received on YouTube recently.
We still don't know why he targeted people who were shown on TV.
Phylus Mathias, no. As yet, nobody has.
But, if he had a personal grudge against Mr. Morioka, that explains one thing. With a strong enough motive, wouldn't he fit and try to kill Mr. Morioka on his own?
Maybe if he were really stupid, he would.
If you think about it that way, it sort of makes sense why Mr. Morioka died without appearing on TV.
Why, Moril, what happened yesterday with Peeve? Wasn't he playing Metal Gear Solid 3 yesterday? Did he have another one of those incidents of falling off a ledge or something? Like he did in MGS 2? Because I would pay to see that again. That's the kind of stuff you just can't make up.
But I wonder what that boy's going to do now that he's in there.
The random person, it's so sad, isn't it, that that's now how low the bar is for Yosuke.
With Teddy on this side, there's no way for him to get out.
Oh, it was MGS. Why, what, did something particular happen, or was he just constantly walking into ambushes and stuff? Ah, okay. Oh, he had some problems with stairs? Oh, poor Peeve. Poor Peeve.
You don't think he's gonna get desperate and end it all?
Well, he won't have to. The shadows will do it for him if we just leave him in there long enough. But no, we've gotta play the heroes and go drag him out before he gets himself eaten by his own subconscious mind. Hey, how's it going? You never get tired of that greeting, do you?
He did look depressed, like it was the end of the world.
Oh, nice, Moral.
The killer has to know that the people he threw into the TV have come back to this side. I can see missing Yukiko or Kanji, but Rise, a celebrity? There's no way the killer wouldn't know she's still alive. So that means he knows there's a way out of the TV world. As for the rest, we'll just have to ask him face to face.
Solid logic, Mimir.
Hey, good timing. How did it go?
Not good. There's not enough information to go on. But at least we're positive that someone's in there.
I see. Wait, where's Teddy?
He's still looking.
Alright. So we need to find out...
Probably not a trap sleeping, Nako, but there's definitely something shady going on here. I mean, because, you know, the whole business with the TV world wasn't already shady to begin with.
And if he is in fact the one the police are after... Once we figure that out, we just do our thing.
That's right.
Basically Doraid, yeah. Teddy is kind of the same thing that Ryoji in P3 was, if that helps.
If he really is the killer and he's escaped into the other world, the police don't have a chance of catching him.
Hopefully, Moral. Hey, Blighted Notion, welcome! Thanks for stopping in.
So it's all...
Oh, Moral, you were offered a day off today?
Well then, let's get digging!
Oh, Inugos, they never give a specific explanation for why he can create the exit. It's just sort of left to the imagination that, yeah, he's a denizen of the other side. I guess he has the power. But yeah, they never really offer you a specific, solid explanation as to why he can. Air can, and he's just the only thing that has enough of a consciousness to be willing to do it. Who knows? Don't think too hard about it. Time is convoluted in Inaba. Well, Demon Protector, we can definitely do the soda part. Although, given that the fox seems to show up fairly regularly, the soda may just be a futile gesture at this point. Oh, I'm sorry, Phylus Matthias. Hey, Russo Hayden, welcome! Alright. So, if I remember correctly... Whoops. Well, Inugos, if we're going with that logic, they're invading the same world all the time. I feel bad for that poor host.
The same bunch of jerkwads keeps invading and ganking me.
Russo Hayden, I might actually have been the first one to greet you, but it takes the stream quite a while to catch up. Not just saying. Blighted Notion, I don't remember off the top of my head how long it's been, but there's an uptime command. You can just ask Moobot, he'll tell you. Exactly, handsome Robles. Oh, let's see. Revolver Ocelot, thank you very much for the $1 donation. Revolver Ocelot says, this is the greatest handgun ever made, the Colt Single Action Army. 6 bullets, more than enough to kill anything, that moves. I appreciate it. Very much appreciate it, although unfortunately, that has changed since then. And I would go so far as to say now probably that the JTLE now occupies that role. Oh, Phyly. Alright, so I believe we need to talk to a couple of people who have information on Fishface over there. I believe the first... Oh, hey, there's Yukiko. Yeah, I guess in a culture like this, it'd be pretty difficult to stop people who are past... Oh, right, the cat! Meow, meow. He's still hungry, but I don't have any food. Damn it. Oh, bye, bird. Sure. Yeah, Chaos, I know to talk to Kanji, but I can't find him. Oh, here he is. I thought he was around here somewhere. Right to the source. Oh, yeah! That's right! Ask my uncle. He'd tell me something. The thing is, if I bring this up with Dojima, Dojima is just going to get suspicious that I'm poking my nose into it. Yeah, and of course, Chaos, he does tell us to ask the police because, you know, they're doing such a great job handling this. I love Persona 3 and 4. As a matter of fact, you'd probably love Digital Devil Saga as well. That also has a fantastic soundtrack, just a different style. Alright, where's Uncle Dojima? There he is. Really? Seriously? You just flat out asked him for a clue? Didn't even try to finesse it out of him, just, hey, Uncle Dojima, you know that thing you told me not to get involved in? How about you tell me about it? Tizona, the P5 trailers look pretty promising so far. But really more than the trailers, I'm just glad they've taken the time they needed and delayed the game long enough to make it a good game. And sure would be nice if more developers did that these days instead of rushing release dates to placate everybody who wants their financial reports to look pretty. No, I will not give you a clue about the case. Oh no, where's that idiot who really likes to give you clues about the case? Okay, take care, Just Alex. Thanks for stopping in. Have a good night. JDL, if you like what you've seen so far in P4G, well, if you can find a PS4 at a decent price. Exactly, Chaos. Well, Phylus, the thing is, Atlas cares. Atlas is a good company, but there's already some pretty bad stuff coming out of them being bought by Sega Sammy. I don't know if you caught the interview a couple of weeks ago now, I think it was, but Nippon Ichi Software broke off its relationship with Atlas. They'd been publishing Atlas games in the West, particularly in Europe, for a long, long time. But some representative from Nippon Ichi went on record as saying that ever since Atlas was purchased by Sega Sammy, they suddenly got super greedy, pushing partners that are going to shower them with money. So, you know, I kind of see that as not so much Atlas, but Sega sticking their noses in where they don't belong and messing things up. And if Sega continues doing that and does it on a progressively larger scale, as I fear they're probably going to do if they're willing to do that much now, then I don't know. The future is not going to be that bright for Atlas, which deeply saddens me. And yeah, Atlas was kind enough to maintain the Demon's Souls servers for all this time, Zane, but I don't know. I feel like anything that Sega touches is just going to burn down. I mean, look at all of their franchises these days. Tizona, all of these games are turn-based. They'd better be ready to publish the games in the EU, Talios. Hey, Eleni, welcome! Oh, you know what? It occurs to me. We still have to go hand in the Fox's quest. Oh, for God's sake, Chie. Stuffing your face with beef when we're trying to solve a case. Fine. You finish your beef bowl. I'll be busy saving the world. Yeah, Execurin, that's not to say that Nippo Nichi couldn't have done a better job with the publishing, but... you know, it still speaks to the fact that they're no longer willing to work with Atlus because Sega is being greedy. That still doesn't bode well, you know? Alright. Damn it, and I should have tried to catch bugs first, because that didn't take any time. Oh, the Red Longitude, I can't say I've ever really thought about that. Oh, Azrite. Foxes are... they're considered to be... divine messengers in Japan. What the... Whoop Whoop, thank you for the $1 donation. Whoop Whoop says, pull over, yo ass too fat. Okay. I think I might be missing a guess. I appreciate the support. Hey, side character, welcome! Thanks for stopping in. Increasing the tea budget, Filey. Well, the Fox rank up certainly doesn't hurt. Hey, Lindsay! And I hung out with the Fox and talked about video games and manga. And then I went home.
Welcome home!
Oh, there was a delivery for me! It's the kitchen knives I ordered! Excellent! Kitchen knives, giant candy, and a prize sticker. What a sweet deal. Alright, let's see here. How good are those? Holy crap, they almost double Yosuke's attack power. Plus 10 strength. Okay, I think President Tanaka deserves a little bit of credit here. Because in Persona 3, he was a scumbag who sold scam products that were garbage. He was basically Billy Mays, except not such a likable and interesting guy. But now, ever since P3, he seems to have gotten his act together. I guess the P is canon. Because, boy, Tanaka is selling some legit merch now. My God. Jesus Christ, these references. Thank you, Otacon, for the $1 donation. Otacon says, can love bloom on the battlefield? Well, Otacon, why don't you go ask Naomi? I'm sure she'll be able to help you figure that out. Thank you, Otacon. Bahamut, yeah, I love the idea of Billy Mays just offering you Persona accessories. Hey, Billy Mays here with the amazing new anti-fire accessories. Guaranteed to raise your fire defense. I can't. Oh, for God's... side character. Side character, thank you so much for the $20 donation. Side character says, Aloha from Hawaii. Spy, this is only the second stream of yours I've been able to catch since I'm usually at work. Your P4G and DS3 playthroughs have made you one of my favorite YouTubers. Gotta head out now, but I'll be sure to watch the VOD later. See ya. Side character, thank you so much for the donation and for stopping in. Now that Motorcycle Guy is done ruining the audio. Yeah, side character, I really, really appreciate the support, and I'm glad you've been enjoying the stream. Take care, have a good day, and enjoy the VOD when you get around to it. Thank you again. Yeah, Holo Process, I don't do a good Billy Mays impression. I would need a little bit of time to workshop it. Could do a little bit better if I'm New Game Plus. Brindleson. Yes, we'll give Miyazaki all the credit for this great DLC. Well, Bahamut, this is the beauty of the internet. And sure, there's a ton of ugliness on the internet, but I think there's some beauty as well. And I think we just found a little bit of it. Alright, we do not... We're not ready to harvest those vegetables yet. I think let's go do the... I open the fridge. There's a container of barley tea. Oh, interesting. Drink it? I'm a little bit suspicious of this. Just a little bit. I kind of have a bad feeling about this. Yeah, the idea that... Pour it on my plants. You see, the thing is... If I had thought to save the game before doing this, I might be a little bit more inclined to drink it. But I have a feeling that what looks like Mugicha is actually going to turn out to be something else, because they do that with quite a lot of the items in the fridge here. They just troll you, like... They tell you it's barley tea, and oh hey, idiot, that wasn't barley tea! That was actually a container of vomit, and now you're sick! And you're going right to bed, and you miss your social link opportunity. Oh... Yeah, water the wet, or it turns out to be Drano. I have a bad feeling about this. Alright, I'll drink it, but if you nerds cost me the opportunity to go hang out with that creepy nurse at the hospital... What the... Miyazaki. Thank you, Miyazaki, for the $1 donation. I'm glad you had something left over from the Dark Souls 3 budget. Miyazaki says, why you no like my game? Miyazaki, I like your game just fine. I just wish that my friend and not a Let's Play. The thing is, Demon Protector, I can't save scum first. If I back out of this menu, I won't be able to drink the tea. I'll miss my chance. But if I drink it, there's a fairly good chance it will turn out to be poison, and I will have to go straight to bed. Russo Hayden, why you wanna PvP me? What'd I ever do to you? Alright, chat, fine, I'll drink it. But don't say I didn't warn you. In before poison. Yup. It was really udon soup based. See, I told you! That was a horrible- Decided to go to bed early. See? This is what I'm talking about, chat. It was actually poison. Oh, lovely, and it saves the data. Alpha, thank you. All I can tell you is neither can I. Oh, shut up, Zoro, dude. Udon soup is yummy, Fablevason. Pure udon soup base is just sodium. Thank you for the other $1 donation, Miyazaki. Miyazaki says, you know like poise now? Miyazaki, I'll have you know. I'll have you know, I saw the interview you did about poise. I'm on to you, man. I'm on to you, Miyazaki. I've seen this. Don't think I don't know your game. Well, I guess I'll just have to catch up on the Devil's Social Link at the end of the game then. Well, all right. This is what happens when I listen to my viewers. we've all learned this lesson before. All right, let's see. That was a while ago, Water the Wet, but yes. Alright, I think we have a couple more prerequisites that we need to meet. Thanks, Nanako. Oh. What even... Thank you, Coming Soon, for the $1 donation. Coming Soon says, the stunning Franz Marcus Dojinshi said in ancient scenic Boletaria, can love bloom on the battlefield. This is getting a little bit too meta even for me. This is ridiculous. I should have leveled resistance, Mimir. Is taking that advice. Yeah, Filey, you should be used to it by now. Alright. A wall paprika and barrier corn salad? Corn is a vegetable, right? Yes, corn is a vegetable. The bottle said salad oil. Well, yes, but you use salad oil with other ingredients. I mean, most people do. This poor woman just can't catch a break. All right. Oh, thank you so much, Prancer. Good luck with your project, and thanks for sticking around for the stream. Have a good night. Take care of yourself. Russo Hayden, I can't take credit for it, but, it definitely encapsulates, the sentiments of a fairly large part of the community, I think. Oh god, here we go again. Miyazaki, again, thank you. Miyazaki says, "This man in video, this not me, you make me sad, poise is perfect." Which... I can't deal with these fucking troll donations. You people, why? Why do you do this to me? Meta, thank you for the $1 donation. Meta says, "You know, I've got to thank you clowns for lifting my spirits after the way the DS3 LP has been going and all of the stupidity and cancer that I've had to wade through every time I upload an episode of it. Thank you. I needed that laugh. I appreciate it." And yeah, the $1 are nice as well. $1. The dollars. I can't language. Yeah, you were investigating the snack counter, weren't you, Adachi? Oh, I'm gonna tell Dojima on you. Unless you give me some information about the case. Actually, I think Blatt's in most countries. He had a part-time job in the shopping district. Huh. Has purposely leaked some information. Bahamut, just go read the comments. You'll see pretty quickly what's been going on. Alright. Oh, is it Sozai Daigaku, Chaos? I was just gonna go down the line and check all the shops, but, okay. Let's see. Not a smart move, my friend. Let's see, Rasta Hamsta, there is quite a lot of cancer, but, there are also a number of people who are well-intentioned and are trying to be supportive and are being kind. But there's still a lot of cancer. Like, a lot. And the reason I continue to read through those comments is because of the people who are making the effort to be nice and who are trying their best to be reasonable and civilized even if they don't agree or don't like something, but the cancer is pretty serious. Alright. That donation. Let's see. Cutting Wolf, thank you very much for the $5. Cutting Wolf says, "All I want you to say is God and blessing of the not sun on your journey." Thank you, Cutting Wolf. I really appreciate it. The donation and especially the encouragement. Very grateful to you, sir. Thank you. Sir or ma'am. Aha! He got bored cutting meat and decided to move on to people. Maybe he is a killer. The person who worked here before him was his classmate during middle school. Okay. He dyed his hair golden brown. Interesting. Let's see. Yeah, Decoy Black Mage, welcome to my life. Oh, just, what is with all these hearts? Thank you, everybody. Jeez, guys, really appreciate the support. You're all the best. Thank you, everybody. Dat Greedo, I didn't upload it while streaming. It was uploaded actually earlier today. And it finished uploading around an hour or two before the stream. Because I was really late with the upload. Oh, Phylus Matthias, did I miss a message from you? Let me go back and check. I have a lot going on at any given time. Oh, okay. Oh, no, Phylus Matthias, no, you're not crazy at all. And I appreciate the sentiment. Certainly would be nice if we could, but I just think there are too many uncompromisingly opposed perspectives now for everybody to be willing to reconcile with one another. And I guess there's nothing left for us to do today other than social links. Because I think that's the last prerequisite that we can fulfill today. Oh, for goodness sake. Motorcycle guy. Oh, and actually Alpha as well. Alpha, thank you so much for the $1 donation. Alpha says, bye, Franz. Going to ditch your stream to watch your latest LP episode. Here is some support. Thank you so much for the support, Alpha. I really appreciate it. And I hope you enjoy the LP episode. I'm glad to hear that somebody is, at least. Motorcycle Guy, thank you for the $1 donation. Motorcycle Guy, I suppose, forgivably, given all the crap I've given him, says, fuck your playthrough, Kappa. Well, motorcycle guy, fuck your motorcycle. But thanks for the donation. Next time you drive by my house, I'm putting down caltrops. You can have that warning in exchange for the donation. Filey, what is this image? Oh, this. I should have seen that coming. All right. What even? Oh, I think we can go take the next quest from the fox.